Today we're at Reliance Stadium in Houston, Texas. This is it, the season nearly over. It's been a great year with plenty of memorable moments and incredible plays. Today's matchup promises more of the same as the Colts square off against the Texans. Now let's go to midfield for the game's coin toss. They're lined up and ready for the kickoff, so let's go to the field for the start of the action. This one is taken by Northcutt. Northcutt accelerates and takes it down to the 44. Should be a beauty with two of the most talented defensive units in the league.
Y'all know the defense wins championship. We will be watching two of the best that the NFL has to offer in this one. And since both of these teams really get after the quarterback and create a lot of pressure, don't be surprised if we see a lot of takeaway.
Hand off to the tailback. Number 59 comes up to make the play at the 48.
Now they got to keep going at it. They can get that defense tired and on its heels. These games will get longer and bigger as the game goes on.
The Texans line up in a 4-3. The pass.
He put the ball exactly where you want to put it.
Looking to run it here. Setting up play action with the pass. He finds his man. Reed won't get enough for the first. Nothing happening on that drive, and they'll punt it away. Past the goal line, no return here. It's first and 10. Indianapolis comes out in their nickel package. Dropping back to pass on first down. Throwing. It's batted away.
And that's just the kind of play they've come to expect from him. He always seems to make the big play just when they need him to.
Stokely was his intended target. The Colts come out in a nickel package. Drops back, gets rid of it, and it's complete. Marshall makes the catch for a pickup of 5 on second down. Indianapolis comes out in a dime package. Dropping back, throwing, and it's caught. Sanders takes him down at the 43. He gets the first down reception and then some. Ball on their own 43. Noel scans the defense from the gun. Blitz is coming. On the move. Ooh, nearly picked off. Gardner had his hands on it.
He's a pretty good cover linebacker. He can run with most guys, and he gets good position. Then he reads the pass, and he makes his move. but he'll drop a few like that one.
Second and 10. Ball on the 43-yard line.
Noel from the shotgun. Throws it, and it's complete. Coleman pulls him down. Marshall makes the catch, but doesn't get very far.
And that's what the mark of a solid defense is. They close in on you in a hurry, and they don't miss tackle.
The Colts come out in a dime package. Dropping back, throwing. And he hits his target. He gets the pass to his receiver, who will come up just short of the first down.
You're never sure why a quarterback chooses that pass instead of one deeper downfield on that third down situation.
Fourth and one coming up. To keep the offense on the field here, aggressive play calling. Hand it off to the back. Right. Records the stop at the 44. Just simply power football there, converting on fourth down.
Let me tell you, the defense knew it was coming. They dug in, and they did their best not to get knocked off the line. But the offensive line just really wanted that one.
Noel, back in the shotgun. Dropping back to pass on first down. With the pass, broken up.
All he can do is look at his hands and wonder what the heck happened.
Ninth play of this drive. Drops back with the throw. It's batted away. Brack had the coverage on the play.
Brack on the coverage.
Third and 10. This is the 10th play of this drive. Yard line.
Everything you got.
Gets rid of it. And it's caught. He's taken down at the 34-yard line.
This is a good play for third and long. When you get that kind of execution from your offense in a situation like that, you're doing something right.
Misdirection. Number 41 comes up to make the play at the 32-yard line. Davis gets the call on the counter, short gain about a yard. And this is the 12th play of this drive. Indianapolis lines up in a 4-3. They're coming with the blitz. Throwing. This pass is incomplete. Kingston was the one they were trying to get the ball to. And this is the 13th play of this drive. The Colts come out in a nickel package. Dropping back, gets the pass off. Doss is the guy who's there to bring it down at the 9-yard line. They have the momentum here.
They're darn near unstoppable on third down. They've just been calling the right plays at the right time.
Yards will get them 6 points. Throwing. Touchdown, Texans.
This is a good play by the offense in the red zone. The wide receiver is going to break away right here and come up with a catch and the touchdown.
The extra point attempt is good. Marshall came up with several big receptions on that touchdown drive, John.
And you know, when I talked to him last week, he said they were really going to try and get him the ball more.
Sends it sailing. From the 4-yard line.
It's still very early. This is one of those spots where you'd like to be able to respond and put the ball in the end zone.
Ball on their own 22. On the ground. Fakes the handoff. Going long. Incomplete. So he's able to break up that pass and then saves what would have been a very big game.
Second and 10. Ball on the 22-yard line.
A little misdirection. Williams drags the ball carrier down behind the line. They wind up in reverse that time. Good push in the middle of the line.
Yeah, it doesn't matter who you are. If the defense gets that much penetration, you're going to go backwards.
Ball on their own 19. Houston comes out in a 4-3. Dropping back. Throws it. And he's pushed out of bounds at the 32-yard line.
Now this is one heck of a play. Look at it. They're in a hole here on third down. And they come through with this perfect play that gets them a first and keeps the drive going.
Direction. Number 59 makes the play at the 37-yard line.
When you have a good balance of run and pass on offense, the defense doesn't have a chance to focus in on either one of them. They need to be prepared to cover both options.
Only one man back. After one quarter of play, the score is 7-0, Texans. The teams have switched sides, and we'll start the second quarter. Ball on their own 37.
Ball on the 37-yard line.
Let's go now.
From the gun. Here comes the blitz. Armstrong takes him down. Excellent recognition by the receiver, reading the coverage and adjusting his route accordingly.
Option routes are receiving routes designed to take advantage of the coverage. It's up to both the receiver and the quarterback to make the same read. If the receiver reads zone, but the quarterback reads man, you can see passes going right to defenders.
The Texans come out in a nickel package. Sends this pass out of play. He couldn't find a receiver, so he threw it where no one could get it. Ball on their own 46. Out of the gun. Pump faking. Throws it. Intercepted.
He's back in his zone. He's reading. He sees the quarterback the whole way. And then he gets a chance at an interception. He just didn't finish the play.
Houston comes out in their nickel package. Is there for the tackle at the 26.
On third and long, the defense is playing pass all the way. They just can't come up with a stop. Watch it here. The quarterback looks and fires one, and the defense is left to wonder how they let him off the hook.
Manning with a man in motion. The rush is on. Gets the pass off. It's broken up.
He has to do a better job of looking off the coverage before he makes a throw like that.
Reed was the intended receiver on that play. Only one man in the backfield.
One man, 36, let's scream. Yeah, you see me. Keep moving. Hey, watch the ball.
Looking upfield. Nice play fake. With the throw, he hits his receiver.
Number 59
comes up to make the play. Manning, clearly regarded as one of the most accurate passers in the league, and with passes like that, you know what.
Yeah, you know what? When he lets it go, he's not trying to throw it in the direction of his receiver. He's trying to hit him right in the hand, put the ball right at their fingertips, and most of the time he doesn't.
So they're inside the 20, need to get a touchdown. Baker is there on the stop at the 17. And they falter again, trying to pick up that yard or two. Adam Vinatieri comes in for what will be a 35-yard field goal attempt. The veteran connecting for the field goal. Following the field goal, the score is 7-3. Texans. Vinatieri in to kick this one off. Decent kick. We should have a return. This one is handled by Buchanan. Here's an opening. He returns this one all the way for the score.
And what you're going to see here is a good example of how you can set up blocking on kick return. Watch how they create a crease for him. He sees his lane, makes some moves, and then he's gone.
Special teams touchdown will clearly provide a spark.
Yeah, when you get that kind of play in a game, no matter what the situation is, you start to feel like you can accomplish anything.
Not a bad kick. They'll set up for the return from the 5.
This is where you want to respond quickly, or this could turn into a battle for field position.
First and 10. The Texans come out in a 4-3. With the carry, Jackson is there on the stop at the 32.
As a coach, you need to make sure that you establish your running game as a weapon that can hurt the other team.
It's second down and 6 to go. Nickelback in this time. Gets rid of it, makes the adjustment. Baker makes the tackle at the 36-yard line. Ball on their own 36. Hands it off. They'll go with a play fake. Pass falls incomplete.
This guy's so strong, he was able to get that pass away.
Hanson will come in now to punt it away. Buchanan into return. From the 20-yard line. Buchanan with some good moves and gets good yardage, bringing it back to the 30-yard line. Almost at the 2-minute mark now. Indianapolis using three linebackers. With a counter play, Simon is there for the tackle at the 29-yard line. Very little blocking to work with on that play.
Yeah, that's just great play from the defense. They play with great leverage up front and always seem to get penetration. When you have defenders in the backfield, it makes it very difficult to run or pass.
Huge hit.
He runs like a cornerback and he hits like a linebacker. This is just the kind of guy you want in your secondary.
2-minute warning coming up. Indianapolis comes out in their nickel package. Minutes to go. Roll out of the gun. Looking for the long completion. And he just can't hang on.
That's a little surprising. The receivers coach has been spending extra time with all his guys on offense working on mechanics and their technique. He told me that he's seen a big improvement. With a big drop on third down like that, shows that they still need a little more work.
From the 38. The Texans come out in a nickel package. They're coming with the blitz. With the pass, Buchanan comes up to make the play at the 47.
Here's a no huddle. It's a good way to keep the defense off balance.
With the throw, he finds his man. The 30. Armstrong is the guy who's there to bring him down at the 19-yard line. The coach is having them hurry it up. Kenny comes in motion. Blitz is coming with the pass. The pass falls incomplete.
Look at the big old defensive lineman. He does a heck of a job of getting in the passing lane and knocking down the pass.
Manning sends a man in motion. Lawrence moved a little early there.
Yeah, the rule for the offensive line is once you put your hand down, you can't move until the ball snaps.
Monroe, the lone setback. Hand it off. Williams with the stop at the 23.
You know what this does? It keeps one defense on the field. And it doesn't let them get the right personnel in there sometimes.
They're blitzing with the pass. Baker comes up to make the play at the 14-yard line. Northcutt made the catch but was unable to get the first down. They'll bring the deficit to within a touchdown if they can make this field goal. The attempt is good.
The key to winning is having your drives get some sort of points for your team. They got it done on that drive. And I'm sure they'll think a touchdown for their next one.
It's on its way. From the 4-yard line. Wayne is the injured player on the field. He'll be coming out for this next play, so we'll find out what the story is. Ball on their own 22. Blitz is coming. Throws on the run. He hits his receiver. Gardner makes the tackle.
What they're doing here is keeping the defense from huddling up. It keeps the same defense on the field.
Pass play here on first down. Throwing. And the catch is made.
I like to hurry up here. It's a change of pace, and it's a way to get the defense uncomfortable.
Drops back with the pass. Incomplete pass. Marshall was his intended target. Wayne is back in there after getting taken out with an injury earlier. The Colts come out in a nickel package. Gets the pass off. Brackett comes up to make the play at the 48.
This is good communication between the quarterback and his receiver to keep the chains moving. They know where the first down marker is, and they recognize the type of coverage the defense is playing. The ball is there, and so is the catch.
Trying something to the left. This pass is incomplete. Number 41, Hopkin, to save a big play.
Second and 10. Ball on the 48-yard line.
Throwing. And he makes the grab. Coleman is there on the stop at the 43. They want to hurry it up here. The blitz is on. The pass ball is incomplete. Well, they're not quite in field goal range, so they'll just keep the offense out there and try to convert on fourth down. Drops back with the pass. Knocked away. So it was second and short, then third and short, then fourth and short, and they can't get the job done. Manning with a man in motion. Pressure, and he's hit as he throws. This pass is incomplete.
I don't think they can do much more than just throw one long. So I'm sure the defensive coach is telling his guys, don't get beat deep.
The Texans come out in a nickel package. Under pressure, he can't get away. The big man gets in there for a big sack.
He's got a great combination of size and move. He won't be winning any races, but he's good at getting after the quarterback. And let me tell you, you never want him to be the guy falling on top of you.
Going into halftime, the score is 14-6. Texans. Vinatieri is just about ready to kick this one away. Nice kick. Plenty of distance. From the 4-yard line. Philip Buchanan accelerates and takes it down to the 36. So they have first and 10 here. The Colts come out in a dime package. Throwing. And this pass is completed. Fisher comes up to make the play at the 43-yard line. He found a soft spot in the coverage, John.
The receiver did a great job reading the coverage. He found a hole in the zone, and the quarterback found him in that hole with the pass.
Indianapolis comes out in a 4-3. A little misdirection. Simon gets right in there and brings him down.
The running game is pretty non-existent so far.
It's third down and four to go. Noel will work out of the shotgun. Dropping back with the throw. Knocked away. That's his third drop. Nothing happening for the offense there. Forced into a three and out. From the 17. Northcutt doesn't have a whole lot of room to work with, getting it to 27-yard line. Ball on their own 27. Houston comes out in their nickel package with a deep throw to the right side. What a catch. Buchanan comes up to make the play at the 26.
I enjoy watching Peyton Manning play. He's kind of a throwback in that he calls most of his own plays. And I kind of like that. He's just a fun guy to watch.
Ball on the 26-yard line. Houston goes with a four-man front. Clark comes in motion. It off. Crocker is there on the stop at the 18-yard line.
On the offense, number 66, still first down.
A team has to show discipline and execute properly out there. If they don't, they'll find it's much harder to overcome the other team and get a win.
It'll be first and long here after the penalty backs them up. Manning will work out of the shotgun. Going to the air on first down. Throwing. Almost picked off.
That was a good play, turned bad play. Good because their zone defense worked well. Bad because he dropped the interception. That's one he wishes he could have back.
Houston comes out in their nickel package. Gets the pass off. He hits his receiver. He took what he was given, completing the pass.
Yeah, what you want to do as a receiver who's facing zone coverage is to break into the secondary, find a hole, settle down, and show the quarterback your numbers. That was a good job.
Houston comes out in their nickel package. Dropping back, throwing. What a catch. Armstrong records the stop at the 27-yard line. The pass is complete, but not enough of the first. Well short, in fact. This is going to be about a 45-yard field goal attempt. Leonard kicks it through.
Not every drive is going to get you a touchdown, so getting three was big. Now they got to go over what worked and what didn't, so the next drive, we'll get them a TD.
Good distance. From the 1 yard line. They forced a three and out on the last series. First and 10. First and 10. Noel from the shotgun. Gets the pass off. A little off target, but caught. Coleman comes up to make the play. Caught for a first down against single coverage. Ball on the 45-yard line. Roll back in the shotgun. Pass play here on first down. He finds his man. Sanders is there on the stop at the 35-yard line. They throw it and pick up a second consecutive first down.
Well, when you start to establish something, you want to keep it going until the defense finds a way to stop you.
Indianapolis with six defensive backs. Throwing. And it's complete. Goss makes the play at the 23.
This is a great block. Watch here. He just barrels into the defender, taking him right off the turf. Now that is a textbook block right there. Sometimes in zone coverage, a quarterback will throw to a spot where his receiver is supposed to be. That time, the only one there was a defender who couldn't make the catch.
Ball on the 23-yard line.
The defense lines up in the nickel. Going deep, looking for something in the end zone. He goes up and grabs it. Marshall bails his quarterback out by making a spectacular catch.
Yep, that was an unbelievable catch. That took the ability to block out the entire field and focus on bringing him in.
It's first and goal at the one. Marshall helped his yards after catch average go up on that last play. Their last red zone trip resulted in a touchdown. A little misdirection. Touchdown, Texans.
When it comes to a play like this, the lowest man with the best leverage is going to generate the biggest push. Seems that the offense got plenty low on that play.
Vanderjagt comes in for the extra point. The extra point attempt is good.
Scoring a touchdown not only puts points on the board, it sends a message to the other team that if you execute properly, they won't be able to stop you. And they say 90% of the game is half mental.
Jordan comes in to kick off. From the 5-yard line.
This team is going to have to focus a lot more than they did in the first half if they're going to come back.
First and 10. Houston comes out in their nickel package. Going long. In and out of his hands.
He's always been able to catch a ball. He has soft hands and good body control. He ran a good route, and the quarterback made the right read. He just didn't bring it in.
Only one man back. Boy, the counterplay. Can't pull him down. Russell comes up to make the play at the 44-yard line. They'll call this play at the line of scrimmage. Throws it. Sell is there on the stop at the 44. Great throw to beat the zone.
I'll tell you, the defense has to do a better job of coming up and clamping down on the receiver whenever he enters their zone.
So after that nice catch and run, here's a look at his stats. Houston lines up in a 4-3. Clark moves in motion. Looking upfield, can't get it away. They brought an all-out blitz, John, and took him down for the loss.
They get pressure on him from all angles. He didn't have a chance.
Now they're looking at second and long after the sack. The Texans come out in a nickel package. So we've reached the end of the third quarter with the Texans ahead of the Colts 21-9. The teams are set for the fourth quarter of play. Ball at about midfield. Houston comes out in their nickel pack. Drops back. Pressure coming. Gets rid of it. It's batted away.
And there's not one wide receiver who can ever claim he's never dropped a pass. It's just part of the game.
Third and 14. Ball on the 48-yard line.
Manning out of the gun. With the pass. The pass is picked off. Has room. The 20. The 10. 5. Touchdown, Texans. He returns the interception for 6 points here in the final quarter. Vanderjagt comes in to attempt the point after. The extra point attempt is good. Jordan will be kicking off. All of that one from the 5 yard line.
They need one quick score and then some more.
First and 10. The lone back hands it off, looking for the long completion. Jumps up and he has it. Crocker is there on the stop at the 41.
Perfect execution to get this first down. Look at it here. He knows how far they have to move the chain, and he gets it by making the right decision and laying it in there like that.
He hands it off, fakes the handoff with the pass. It's caught.
Number 59
records the stop.
This is what they have to do. Keep making completions down the field and move the chains. Watch this one. He knows he's got to get the first, and he picks the right guy to throw it to.
Closing in, going long to the left. Drops the interception. Oh, man, he had it in the end zone, but dropped it.
That's the second worst thing that can happen to a defender, to drop one like that. The absolute worst thing is to have your man beat you for six.
Manning back in the shotgun. Reed comes in motion. It's a blitz. This pass is incomplete.
Creating pressure can really change the way an offense operates. They need to keep some extra blockers in. Either a tight end on the line or a back that can help them out with their protection.
Armstrong is there for the tackle at the 14-yard line.
Number 75, first down.
Houston comes out in their nickel package. Aimed it off to the back. Buchanan is there on the stop at the one.
Hey, if you can keep running the ball in the fourth quarter as you're playing catch-up, that's an advantage that you have over the defense because it keeps them off balance.
Looking for the goal line. And he's brought down at the one-yard line. He makes his fifth stop of the game on that play. It's second and goal at the one. Monroe, the lone setback. Touchdown, Colts.
I tell you, they just knocked that defensive line backwards on that play. Watch it here. The offensive line explodes off the ball. The defense can't get any penetration, and the runner is in the end zone.
The point after is good. The Colts have just made it a two-score game.
This team can put up some points, but this might be a little too deep a hole.
They have to get the ball back quickly, so they're going to try the onside kick. Here we go. From the 42-yard line, the Texans will start the drive from the 43. First and 10. The Colts line up in a 4-3. With a counterplay. The 30. June is there for the tackle at the 27-yard line. Excellent execution on the counter, John.
Yeah, he made some moves and broke free. And one of the things he does best is use his blocks downfield. He's very patient, and he waits for his blockers to engage. Then he cuts off their hip for a big gain.
Ball on the 27-yard line. They line up in the I formation. Gets the call. Comes up to make the play. Davis runs it through the middle, a gain of about six. Almost at the 2-minute mark now. They'll go from the I formation. Hand it off to the back. Brackett is there for the tackle at the 20. The 17-yard line is where they have to go for a first. So with the ball in the red zone, they have a very good chance of extending that lead. They give it to the halfback. Simon makes the tackle.
Teams run in the middle about 80% of the time, and that's inside the tackle. So you have to be able to have some success doing it. This time, there was no problem getting it up in there.
The Colts line up in a 4-3. Great move. Mike Doss was in on the play again for another tick on the stat sheet. They need 7 yards for a touchdown. Indianapolis using three linebackers. He He hands it off. June comes up to make the play. At the 4-yard line, he bulldozes through the line for the first. Four more yards to the end zone. Davis, the deep man. It off to the back. June makes the play at the 2-yard line. Davis battles his way forward for what appears to be a 2-yard pickup. It's second and goal at the 2. They line up in the I formation. Is there for the tackle at the 3-yard line. They're trying to find some room in the middle, but there was no place to go.
I'll tell you what happened. The defense was coming with a lot of guys in a run blitz, and the hole that that play was supposed to go through was filled with defenders.
It's third and goal at the 3. They give it to the halfback. Fisher comes up to make the play at the 3-yard line. Fourth down upcoming, but they're in position to add to their lead.
Yeah, and that's what they wanted to do. Control the ball in the clock, getting into position to have at least 3 points.
This will be from about 20 yards out. The Texans are taking control in this one. Jordan, looks like he's just about ready to kick this one off. And he got all of that one, a great kick. From the 3. So this could be the last play of the game. Not much left they can do here. Even if they score, it's still over. Pass play here on first down. Fakes the throw. Pressure. The pass ball is incomplete. That'll wrap this one up. And the final score is Houston 31, Indianapolis 16. This is Al Michaels with John Madden saying goodbye for EA Sports.